Thank you very much. First, I must thank Dr. Deep Goyal and his team, Deep, Randeep and Sandeep, as somebody mentioned, for this collaborative, collective wisdom. One. And second, I must thank him for thinking that I have started becoming geriatric now. And he has given me the topic of geriatric bariatric. And I am going to speak on expectations, safety, and outcome of surgery. I bring greetings from Institute of Minimal Access, Metabolic, Bariatric, and Robotic Surgery, Sir Gangaram Hospital, and Bhatia Global Hospital, and Endosurgery Institute. Age is nothing but a number. And I have a firm belief on that. Most of times, when we are analyzing that whether we should go in for bariatric surgery in this kind of patient of more than 60 years or 65 years, we should always think that what is the physiological age vis-a-vis chronological age. And I think most important is that I should substantiate this with the data which I brought. And Edward Deming had beautifully written, "In God we trust, all others must bring data." And few publications, the Medical Clinics of North America, the Addressing Obesity in Aging Patient. And in this, they have analyzed that the patients per se, not obese, per se people are increasing in number, and in 2010, 2020, and 2030, the 20% of the population will be more than 65 years of age. In 2030, the 20% of the population in US will be over 65 years of age. Similarly, WHO has also seen and studied that between 2015 and 2050, the proportion of the world's population over 60 will be nearly doubling from 12% to 22%. What I mean to say that this is the area one has to address in the future or in the present also. And as we know that life expectancy has gone above, and this is at the age of 65, our expectations of life are that for males it is 82.8 years and for the females it is 85.3 years. What I mean to say is when we are selecting the patient for bariatric surgery, then one has to think that at the 60 age or 65 age, are we going to discard the patient because the patient is having morbid obesity and comorbidities, or we should offer them so that they are able to live maybe rest of 20 years or 17 years with comfort and the quality of life has improved. And prevalence is that in obese patients, now it is more than 60 years old, and of all the population, 37.5% are males, and of all the population, 39% are females. So thinking is that one has to be ready to offer the best to these kind of patients, that is the bariatric, geriatric patient. And all of us know that whether it is lifestyle management or drugs or other kind of dietary manipulations, but ultimately it is the surgery which has the long-term result rather than the short-term results. And in this paper, in bariatrics, in geriatrics, is an age an obstacle for bariatric surgery? The answer is no. And they studied 48 patients who were more than 65 age. And in that, they analyzed that sleeve gastrectomy was the commonest operation which was being done, of the order of 79%. Rest was mini gastric bypass, 17%. And Roux-en-Y gastric bypass was done in 4%. In this, they found out that ultimately, whether they were doing above the age of 65 or 60 and below the level of the age of 65, more or less the excess body weight loss was similar, 66.8%. And the comorbidities also reduced in the same proportion. It was not different. Most of the time, most of the patients above the age of 60 or 65 are having more comorbidities of diabetes, hypertension, sleep apnea, and so on and so forth. But ultimately, resolution is of the order of diabetes, for example, 65%, hypertension 54%. So thinking is that yes, one should offer them the surgery, but one should analyze it totally. One should investigate them thoroughly so that we are not missing any comorbidities. And from our own country, Dr. Mohit Bhandari had published a beautiful article on outcomes of bariatric surgery in geriatric patients more than 65 years. And in a single institution study, they revealed that more than 65 age, 184 patients were there. And of that, again, the commonest operation which was offered to them was sleeve gastrectomy, but mini gastric bypass also makes a major chunk of 21% and Roux-en-Y gastric bypass of 28%. And the conclusions were that it is definitely beneficial to the patient. It is safe and effective treatment option in a selected, again, underlined, selected geriatric patients. One should definitely investigate them thoroughly and then see whether we are going to offer them the best or not. And functional assessment, for example, if the patient is mobile and if he or she is able to go to the toilet, fend for herself or himself, then it is a functional assessment that we should see rather than discard them on list of comorbidities, for example, knee joints or arthritis or diabetes or hypertension or heart disease. And in this, again, the negative side, the other side of the coin is we should be very much cautious that in any case, the elderly person may have a small muscle mass, the osteoporosis must have set in, the bone density would have been reduced, and there are increased risk of fractures. But if we add the surgery, and if we do the surgery, which ultimately depletes the calcium or depletes the bones of the bone density, and then they lead on to fractures later on, I think we should be refraining ourselves. I hope you can understand what is meant by sarcopenia. Sarcopenia is that the muscle mass is definitely reduced in these outpatients, and one should not carry on decreasing the muscle mass and thinking that they will not be mobile and that is why they are not losing weight. No, I think it has to be a wisdom, it has to be a balance that has to be maintained. Now comparing the two, all of us know that there are two major surgeries which we do, either it is a Roux-en-Y gastric bypass or a sleeve gastrectomy. So in this study, they had done a meta-analysis of comparative studies, and there were seven studies, more than 3,000 patients of age more than 60, and they published that the increased risk of mortality is there of the order of 1%, and the complication rates also increase by 3% if we are operating in an elderly patient vis-a-vis non-elderly patient. But ultimately they made us realize that Roux-en-Y gastric bypass in patients older than 80 years may be a risky bariatric surgery operation due to higher complications and mortality and may not be as effective as in patients younger than 60 years. And the patient should be carefully counseled before the operation. And again, a wonderful study, and it has been published in Sword also, bariatric surgery in the elderly, and they had compared that in non-elderly people vis-a-vis elderly people, the complication rates, the morbidity, the comorbidity reduction. But ultimately, when all of us started bariatric surgery, we were offering to the non-elderly people, and that at the start, the complication rates were higher. But now, with the passage of time, the complication rates in all the surgeons in the experienced hands in the wonderful centers have come down. And now, it has been seen that the complication rates, mortality and morbidity are in elderly are also even lower as compared to non-elderly 15 years back. What I mean to say that one should make sure that all the procedures, as Dr. Sangana was also mentioning about the pediatric patient, so one should do these kind of surgeries should be done by the experienced surgeons, and experienced team, and then only we should touch them. We should not take for granted that these are the bariatric patients and one should go ahead with the surgery because it was told in the conference. And now it has been seen that the comorbidities are definitely, as I mentioned, in elderly patients are definitely higher in those age groups. But the higher morbidity rate in elderly is due to significantly higher comorbidity rate in elderly. For example, hypertension is of the order of 84%, and in non-elderly patients, it is 54%. So one has to again and again assess whether it is a physiological age which we are treating or it is the chronological age which we are treating. Another publication, bariatric surgery in old adults, should there be an age limit? And this study had 451 patients. Again and again, why I am showing this repetitively different studies, that ultimately the sleeve gastrectomy has taken over all over the world, and the rate is 76% patients were offered sleeve gastrectomy, gastric bypass and gastric band were of the order of 10 to 11%, and excess weight loss was of the order of 70%. But most important is they had studied between the age of 65 and 69 and more than 79. We have also, about two more slides, we have also operated on a patient of 79 years and still the patient has been benefited. So our thinking is loud and clear that one has to make it safe and one has to make sure that we do not lead to any complications. In this paper, in this publication from MSQ, this is a Michigan initiative, and they have shown in 16,568 patients that the gastric bypass definitely has a higher complication rates, morbidity rates, side infections, leak, ulcer, and so on and so forth. So one has to be sure when we are offering this kind of patients, whether it is a sleeve gastrectomy or gastric bypass. Another study with 8,000 people, again they have shown the 30-day complication, reoperation, and readmission. Sleeve gastrectomy scores over the gastric bypass. And definitely one should be deciding for the nutritional supplementation which will be required for our kind of vegetarian population later on. Thank you very much for your kind attention. Thanks a lot.
Thank you, Dr. Parveen, for a wonderful delivery. Now,